A teacher plays an important role in any teaching learning process. Distance education is no exception to this. The only difference is in conventional education, the teacher performs the role in front of the students. So they are in front of each other in the face-to-face mode. Distance education provides a different kind of scenario where the teacher may or may not be in front of the learners. And this brings in the various dimensions that the teacher has in case of distance learning. We shall see the role of the teacher in distance learning on two aspects. Number one is when the teacher is not in front of the students, and the second one is when the teacher is in front of the students. So in the first aspect, where the teacher is not in front of the students, the teacher may take the very many different kind of roles or different kind of forms when it comes to the teaching learning process. For example, if the teacher in this case is involved in writing the study material or recording as a audio lecture, and then in that case the teacher is behind the scene or is in the hidden form, especially when it comes to the role of writer. So from that point of view, the teacher is expressed through the writing or through the printed material that is developed. Another role that the teacher plays in this case is also in the form of maybe audio or video, especially audio, where the students cannot see the teacher, can just hear the teacher. In this case, the teacher has to ensure that there is proper voice modulation when it comes to reaching out the students through audio. Now, this audio may be as a part of the static learning material or may be as a part of the counseling, especially in the synchronous or even asynchronous mode. The teacher in this case has to learn the skills of how to behave in front of camera. In general, the teacher is used for the concept of having eye-to-eye contact with the students while teaching. When the teacher is teaching through camera or through, say, video shoots, then in that case, it is the teacher has to acquire the skills of looking only into the camera and imagine that the camera are the students. At times, the teacher is involved into the teaching learning process through audio conferencing. As we have seen earlier, the students may be distributed over a wider geographical area, and the only mode of communicating with them is through audio conferencing. So that here the limitation is the students cannot see the teacher. So the teacher has to ensure that she or he reaches out to the students only through the proper voice modulation. And thus the students then feel that they are with the teacher and the teacher is with them throughout the process of learning. With the advent of technology, the teaching learning process is done through something called as a learning management system. For example, Moodle could be a learning management system. The teacher who is teaching the students through this same Moodle, or maybe at times an option like WizIQ, should be well versed with the various facilities that are available in this learning management system. So the teacher needs to be oriented basically with the various features and which feature is to be used at what kind of situation in the teaching learning process. So the teacher needs to be an expert in that particular learning management system. When this is a computerized system of learning process, The teacher has to ensure that the students have the equal comfort with the teacher, as well as enough of learning opportunities are given to the students during this learning process. We come to the second aspect of the roles of the teacher, which are more of the in the synchronous mode. Now this unlike conventional university, there is a concept of counseling when it comes to open and distance learning. So here as there is teaching involved in conventional system, there is counseling involved in the open and distance learning. Now this concept of counseling is a little different than the concept of teaching. Here the person is not taught as such, but it is one is counseled. So the role of the teacher in this case, or the instructor, or it is also known as counselor, has to take care that the content is properly explained to the learners. Since it is not end-to-end teaching, the counselor does not teach every piece of content from the subject matter, but he or she explains the difficult aspects, or whenever the students or the learner has doubts, that aspect is explained to the learners by the teacher. So the teacher should be able to properly elaborate the content so that the learners are able to understand the content properly. At times, the students are asked to have the group discussions at the time of the contact sessions. The contact sessions are the only chance for the learners and the teachers to interact with each other through face-to-face mode. So it is possible, or rather advisable, that the students are given an opportunity to discuss on certain aspects. This is also an important strategy from andragogy point of view. Now when the students are discussing, what is this teacher doing? The teacher or the counselor in such situations are expected that they go around the groups and supervise the discussion, at times even intervene the discussion and take it on the right track if there are any mistakes that are happening. Thus the teacher has the role of a kind of a supervisor in this case. Another role that this counselor performs at the study center is that of the evaluator. The learners are given assignments as a part of the coursework. The purpose of having this assignment is that they get the feedback on their learning process. They know where they are lagging behind, or which area they need to focus more on, and so on. This is the role performed by the counselor at the study center, who assesses the all the learning assignments. It may be in the form of writing a portfolio, or maybe in the form of preparing a concept map, or maybe writing the just answers to the questions, and so on. So all this coursework is assessed by this counselor and given the feedback to the students. The students get the feedback, which is more of a formative assessment, and thus they know where they need to put in more efforts. The counselor also performs the role of maintaining the important records related to their students. For most of the programs, the attendance for the contact sessions is optional, but especially for some professional programs, some minimum attendance for them is compulsory. So this counselor keeps track of whether that minimal attendance is there for the learners. There also are records related to how many assignments have they submitted, how many of them have been evaluated, whether they are getting the minimum required marks in those assignments, whether the students have filled in the exam forms, whether their results are declared, and so on and so forth. So there is a lot of database needs to be maintained at the study centers, and for particular course all this database is maintained by the counselors for the students. So he also maintains all the record for the students. Now, as the name suggests, the word counselor, the person is also responsible for providing counseling to the students. Now, as we have seen that the students who are enrolled in distance learning, they are in the world of work or they are employed apart from they being studying through distance mode. So they have lot of job responsibilities as well as family responsibilities, and at the same time they are trying to improve their skills, they are trying to study. They face lots of problems during while handling this multiple task. The counselor gives them all the psychological support needed while handling all these multiple responsibilities. He or she also helps them in developing the study habits, the efficient ways of studying, and how do they handle the work as well as their studies simultaneously. They help in motivating the students in a big way. Apart from this, the counselor also has the responsibility of evaluating the program that is being offered. So the person gets the feedback about the program from the students, that are the end users, and passes on this feedback to the university which offers the programs. This provides an important source of data from the learners to the university. Thus, we have seen that the instructor or the counselor has very many responsibilities when it comes to the teaching learning process in the open distance learning. In fact, this counselor or the instructor is the key person in the whole system of distance education. Depending on the kind of inputs that this person gives for the teaching learning process, the learner feels one with the system and is able to adjust in a better manner with the system and get the maximum out of the opportunities offered to the learner.